one of our most successful and prolific homegrown authors, Di Morrissey, has been captivating readers for almost a quarter of a century. She has just released, I know, another page turner. Let's welcome Di Morrissey back to Studio 10. On the show 10 months ago, and here you are with another novel, your 23rd in 24 years.
Oh my God.
Do you eat or sleep, or do you just sit at a computer typing?
Oh, no, I have a great life. I have a great life, but I'm very disciplined, very organised. So I have a month and a half in the place that I'm writing about, and then I go and then I have the bum glue, as Sydney Sheldon calls it, sitting there for 6 or 7 months. But I write 7 days. I can't afford to have writer's block, you know? I mean, I just go for a walk or sleep on it. Wake up in the morning and you go, oh, yes, I know what to do now.
Do you have... do you have... And I don't mean this in a bad way, but do you have a sort of formula or a structure that you stick to? You say you know what to... You know, what points in the book to hit that it's got to do
this thing? Oh, God, no. I start the book with no idea what it's about or where it's going. I've got people in a place and they kind of take me on the journey. By living... Because each book is inspired by a place, so I go there and, you know, by absorbing the colours and the smells and talking to people and the culture and the history and, you know, that's I sort of take all that internally.
And then
I've either got a theme and a main character and I come back with, you know, this one I'm exploring. You know, life doesn't always turn out the way you expect, so it's someone that is forced to change their life.
So this is The Road Back, your latest book.
Yes.
So what place is it set in? And tell us a bit more about it.
Well, I fictionalise it because if you write about a real place and then you write in that the postmistress, you know, is having an affair or is some, you know, child bashing, you can be sued by the real postmistress. So I always rename the place and make some changes. But essentially, I wanted a place because I feel the world is in such turmoil and it's so... We're just in such a terribly dark place that I wanted a place that really what everybody is after all around the world, and that is a place of tranquility, security and peace and beauty. So it's Bellingen, New South Wales.
Oh, gorgeous.
It's northern New South Wales. It's rainforest. It's a very special place.
Your heroines always encounter many obstacles, it seems to me.
And don't we all?
Well, of course. But I wonder if sometimes you're writing about your mother, because she overcame all sorts of obstacles, the death of your dad, the death of your brother, and then she went on to become Australia's first female TV director and film director. What did she teach you?
To never give up and that anything and everything is possible. I mean, yes, she was an amazing role model because, you know, suddenly overnight your life changes with, you know, the death of your husband and my brother, and we were left virtually penniless. Chips Rafferty was kind of my godfather, and he took up a fund for us and helped. So my mother then changed her life, and that's really... what I'm writing about in this book is that you can change your life by circumstances or by choice. That anything is possible. I mean, I keep reinventing myself, really, when I look at it. It just sort of is the way things have evolved. Well, that didn't work out. Gee, I'll do this. Have a shot.
Well, thank you for writing your gorgeous stories about Australia. Di's latest book, The Road Back, lands in bookstores today. And everyone in our audience is going home with a coffee. Di Morrissey, always nice to see you. I think you've got another book to go start working on, actually.
I do have another book to go start
on. I'll have it done by 5 o'clock.
Yeah.